Welcome on lecture number 2, that is the data communication network. Our code is REC701. In this module, previously we have seen the our course objective and course outcomes. Our course objective is very simple: to understand the basic terminology of the networking and evaluate the functions of the various layers and their rules. And there are our CO, CO1, CO2, CO3, CO4 and CO5. This CO1 is distributed according to the our unit. We having the 5 unit: unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, unit 4 and unit 5. So in first unit, all the units are covered in one textbook. That textbook name is Be Frozen, that is the fourth edition, and name is Data Communications and Networking. And there are the so many references book, but if you want to reference the, there is the Data Communication Computer Networks, and that Computer Networks is by Ajit. This by Data Communication, and the writer is Ajit Pal. There are two more books. One book is Modern Digital Analog Communication System by the B.P. Lathi, and this is the Oxford University Press, and this is published in 2010. If you want to refer the reference book, that is the William Stalling's the 6th edition, Prentice Hall, and book name is Data and Computer Communication. This is the 7th semester, and we have planned according that. This is one of the our syllabus, and this is the unit wise, and now we have to start it. Started with the, we have started why we have required this video lecture, because we have know there is a corona is going on, और इस कोरोना के पीरियड में सारे जो चूंकि एक महामारी है, वैश्विक महामारी है, और इस वैश्विक महामारी में आपको घर पे बैठ के ही क्लासेस अटेंड करनी है, लेक्चर्स आपको अटेंड करने हैं, ताकि आप इस कोरोना से इफेक्ट ना हो। और दूसरी चीज़ क्या है, हम अगर अपने सब्जेक्ट की बात करें तो हमारा जो सब्जेक्ट्स है, व्हाट इज़ कम्युनिकेशन नेटवर्क्स इज ऑल अबाउट, दिस इज़ द क्यों हम ये पढ़ना चाहते हैं, हमारे लिए ये क्यों इम्पोर्टेंट है, ये जानना जरूरी है। इस सब्जेक्ट में ऐसा क्या इम्पोर्टेंट स्टडी है जो हम इसके लिए अपना जो कोर्स है कंटेंट्स आपके सामने लेके आए, क्या इसका आपको बेनिफिट मिलेगा, क्या आप अपनी कैरियर को इस फील्ड में डाल सकते हैं, क्या ये जो कैरियर बनाने के लिए इसके लिए आपको क्या करना होगा, कैसे आप कंपनीज को अप्रोच करेंगे, और आपके पास कौन से प्रोफेशनल सर्टिफिकेट की ज़रूरत पड़ेगी, उसके लिए भी एक ओवरव्यू यहाँ पे हम देंगे। और जो कोर्स कंटेंट्स है, जिसमें कि यूनिट वाइज जो कोर्स कंटेंट्स हमारे दिए हुए हैं, जो यूनिट वाइज 1 से लेकर 5 तक हैं, और इस कंटेंट्स में OSI मॉडल और नेटवर्क मॉडल्स के बारे में हम डिटेल्स में पढ़ेंगे, साथ ही साथ क्रिप्टोग्राफी पढ़ेंगे, साथ ही साथ फाइल ट्रांसफर प्रोटोकॉल पढ़ेंगे, ATM पढ़ेंगे, और मल्टीपल एक्सेस टेक्निक्स का भी हम अध्ययन करेंगे, और जो 7 लेयर्स हैं उसके बारे में पूरा डिटेल से पढ़ेंगे। हम ये भी जानेंगे कि जो हमारे करंट सिनारियो में क्यों हम कम्युनिकेशंस को इतना इम्पोर्टेंस देते हैं, क्या ज़रूरत है कम्युनिकेशंस की, चूँकि हम हमारे ये पहले से हम ये जानते हैं कि कम्युनिकेशंस के लिए सबसे ज़रूरी होती है एक नेटवर्क्स की आवश्यकता। कम्युनिकेशंस तभी पॉसिबल है जब दो एंड आपस में एक दूसरे से कनेक्टेड हों, और एक एंड जिसको जो ट्रांसमीटर हम बोलते हैं, जो कि ये टी एक्स है एक एंड, जो रिसीवर है जो कि आर एक्स है, इन दोनों के बीच में आपस में अगर कोई वायर्ड या अनवायर्ड कनेक्शंस है, इसी के थ्रू हम एक मैसेज अपना लेते हैं और देते हैं, मतलब वी कैन सेंड द मैसेज बिटवीन दिस टू एंड्स। और यही कम्युनिकेशंस जब हम नेटवर्क की बात करते हैं, जब दो या दो से ज़्यादा डिफरेंट नोड्स, नोड्स का मतलब यहाँ पे क्या होता है, नोड्स इज रिफर फॉर द कम्युनिकेटिंग डिवाइसेस लाइक लैपटॉप, डेस्कटॉप, मोबाइल, पेजर्स, एंड दिस इज कम्युनिकेटिंग डिवाइसेस विच कम्युनिकेट टू योर डेटा। लेकिन हम क्यों डेटा कम्युनिकेशन क्यों हम प्रिफर कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि पहले के जितने भी कम्युनिकेशंस डिवाइसेस थी वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ वॉइस ही कम्युनिकेट करती थी, वॉइस का ही कम्युनिकेशन होता था। और आज के प्रेजेंट सिनारियो में हम वॉइस के साथ डेटा भी सेंड करना चाहते हैं, और ये डेटा हम सेंड करना चाहते हैं ना केवल जो हमारे पास में है, बल्कि हमसे बहुत बहुत दूर है। और ये भी पॉसिबल नहीं है कि जो लोग दूर हैं उनके बीच में हम कोई वायर की कनेक्टिविटी के, कैसे हम ये काम कर सकें। इसी के लिए सबसे पहले 5 टॉप मोस्ट यूनिवर्सिटीज़ ने एक अर्पानेट प्रोजेक्ट 802 प्रोजेक्ट लेके आए, और ये हमारे लिए जानना है कि इस 802 प्रोजेक्ट्स का हमारे डेटा कम्युनिकेशन, जिसको कि हम शॉर्ट फॉर्म में अगर कहें DCN से क्या रिलेशन है। डेटा कम्युनिकेशन नेटवर्क तभी आया जब 802 प्रोजेक्ट्स के जरिए हमने ये कोशिश की क्या दो कम्युनिकेटिंग मशीन्स आपस में डेटा ले सकती हैं या दे सकती, क्या ये आपस में डेटा एक्सचेंज कर सकती हैं या इनके बीच में डेटा एक्सचेंज किया जा सकता है, क्या ये डेटा के लिए एक दूसरे के साथ कम्युनिकेशन पॉसिबल है। तो उन्होंने ये पाया कि हाँ ये किया जा सकता है, डेटा कम्युनिकेशन पॉसिबल है, और डेटा कम्युनिकेशन हम एक एंड से दूसरे एंड के बीच में कर सकते हैं। और जब उन्होंने देखा कि जब मशीन के बीच में डेटा सेंड किया सकता है, इसी डेटा कम्युनिकेशन को हमने जब दो या दो से डिफरेंट नोड्स, जो कनेक्टिंग नोड्स थे, हमने उन नोड्स के जरिए इनको कनेक्ट करना शुरू किया, और ये डिफरेंट नोड्स जब आपस में कनेक्ट होते हैं या ये एक डिवाइस का फॉर्म करते हैं और एक दूसरे से इंटरकनेक्ट होकर कम्युनिकेशन क्रिएट करते हैं, ऐसे कम्युनिकेशन को हम नेटवर्क करते हैं। जब दो या दो से ज़्यादा हों ये कम्युनिकेटिंग डिवाइसेस, और ऐसे जो ग्रुप हैं, जब ऐसे ग्रुप दो या दो से ज़्यादा ग्रुप आपस में, दो या दो से ज़्यादा ग्रुप जब आपस में एक दूसरे से कम्युनिकेट करें, एक दूसरे से डेटा ले ना केवल बल्कि डेटा एक्सचेंज करें, ऐसे ग्रुप को, ऐसे 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 सिस्टम को हम नेटवर्क कहते हैं। सो नेटवर्क इज नथिंग बट इट इज द कनेक्शन बिटवीन द मोर देन टू और मोर देन टू ग्रुप्स ऑफ कनेक्टिंग डिवाइसेस एंड दे फॉर्म द नेटवर्क। व्हेन द टू और मोर देन टू नेटवर्क्स आर कनेक्टिंग टू ईच अदर, दे फॉर्मिंग द इंटरनेट। सो द इंटरनेट वेयर यू कैन सी दिस, देयर इज ए इंटरनेट वेयर द इंटरनेट ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन इज कैरिड आउट, आइदर वी कैन सेंड और वी कैन रिसीव। सो क्वेश्चन इज दैट कि व्हाई द कम्युनिकेशन नेटवर्क इज इम्पॉर्टेंट। द करंट सिनेरियो वी कैन नॉट ओनली सेंड द डेटा, लाइकवाइज वी कैन सेंड टेक्स्ट, वी कैन सेंड नंबर्स, वी कैन सेंड इमेज, इमेज कैन बी सेंड, सो मैनी थिंग्स आर exchange between the two parties. Now internet is the group of the more than two networks. In between, when the two or more than two groups of networks should be agreed and they have to follow the rules. Once that they have followed the rules, when they understand the guidelines, when they have obeyed the rules, then the internet is coming in the picture. अब आप एक चीज देखो कि आज हमारे पास नेट है और हमारे एक फिंगर टिप से हम कितनी सारी इंफॉर्मेशन ले सकते हैं. लेकिन यहाँ पे मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि एक मिनट इंटरनेट यूज करने से क्या क्या हो सकता है, कितना इम्पोर्टेंट है ये आपका डेटा कम्युनिकेशन नेटवर्क. कि जब आप एक मिनट इसको यूटिलाइज करते हैं और ये टेबल हमने लिया हुआ है, ये ऑनलाइन टेबल हमने इसको डाउनलोड किया है. एक तरफ ये पिक्चर है आपकी 2019 की, ये आपकी 2019 की और एक तरफ आपकी 2020 की है. क्या होता है जब एक मिनट में आप नेट यूज करते हैं, आप यहाँ पे एक चीज कॉमन आप देख सकते हैं इस एक मिनट के अंतर पे. अगर आप इसको देखें, गूगल को देखें, एक मिनट में 2019 में इसके सर्च इंजन को 33.8 मिलियन यूजर्स ने यूटिलाइज किया, सिर्फ और सिर्फ एक मिनट में. ऐसे ही आप फेसबुक देखो, फेसबुक में जो लॉगिन हुए 1 मिलियन पीपल इन जस्ट वन मिनट दे शेयरिंग दी वॉइस डेटा. नाउ सी द व्हाट दिस इज ऑल दिस, देयर आर दिस सो मैनी प्लेटफॉर्म्स. यू कैन सी द यूट्यूब, देयर इज द 4.5 मिलियन व्यूअर्स आर व्यूड यूट्यूब. हाउ द यूट्यूब इज इंपॉर्टेंट इन योर लाइफ. That's why the data communication network is very, very much important. Instagram. The figure you can look at, this is mail. 188 million email is sent in just 1 minute. TweetCH, 1 million views. 41 music streams are downloaded and is available in a 1 minute. WhatsApp Messenger, 41.6 million is available in for just 2019 mein. एक मिनट इंटरनेट यूज किया गया और सिर्फ 41.6 मिलियन यूजर्स ने इसको यूटिलाइज किया. आप नेटफ्लिक्स देखिए, 694444, दिस इज डेटा विच इज टेकन इन 2019. नाउ कम इन टू 2020. In 2020, where the data in 2019 3.8 million, now it is rise 4.1 million people are search the Google platform. Facebook, where the, if you look at this Facebook, only 1 million people are there to log in the Facebook. But here 1.8 million in just 1 minute, 0.3 million users are increased because of the importance of the data communication network. YouTube, look at 4.7, here 4.5, you can see 190 million users are used to email. and here 188 million users are using. How much data is utilized through the internet? This is the 59 million users are using the WhatsApp. Therefore, 41.6 million. Now, it is very important to you know your course, and then your course is so much important, and it is the latest course. You can choose your career in this field by learning the data communication network. There are the so many careers options are available. So many careers. It started from the network specialist. You can join the network specialist. You can join as a network technician in telecom sectors. You can join the BTS and others companies for wireless infrastructures engineers. You can also use the cloud networking architect to work as a cloud. A cloud is the very important platform where all the informations, the huge number of the data is acquired and stored in the cloud. You need the Google Drive, you need the huge amount of data. When data is accessed from 10 MB, then cloud is start to working. This is your field. There is a main concern about the security. You can work as a network security specialist, and you can work also VoIP engineer as you can work VoIP. If you are working a big multinational company, there is a data center network specialist. All the data, mobile data, others data, your office data, your research centers data, your big institution who are working in research work, they required the data specialist entry. They have given a lot of job in this area. You also work as a network quality insurance engineer. As you have, you use your knowledge and you adopt these options as a career, and you have developed the configuration among the different institution, technical institution, private institutions and offices. You can also work as a quality insurance engineer for providing the certification. You are also having the one career options for working in network manager. There is a mobility solution architect career options. The option is the network solution architect. All the networking devices having a certain time of problems, you can solve it, you can resolve it, either regarding to modem, either regarding to internet connection, other regarding to your function connections connectivity. You can adopt this network solution architect. You can also work as a network engineer. There is a big scope in telecom project manager, and the biggest advantage is the network administration. There are a lot of the career options. Once you enter in this, there is a networking research and development specialist job. These are the different career options. These are different jobs you can adopt after the learning of this data communication networks. This is the basic outcomes. Everyone wants the job. after the completing your BTech, there is an option in your hand. But once you are entering the big companies, then what you do now? You are having the different skill set. They are requiring the different skill set. And the companies is offering the different packages according to your knowledge, according to your certification. And you are also having the different work environment, different companies having the different environment. And once you are involved, that the nature of work is the most important scenario in your life. You having like the job, you work hard, then you also accept the challenges. These challenges is better your career, provide a better option in your career. Now move, how you get these jobs, how you say where we go now after the competition, after the complete your graduation. You need a certain certification, and on the behalf of this certification courses, you can enter in this different discipline jobs. Cisco is offering these certification courses, and there are the different certificate courses according to networking technicians, designs, network associates, professionals, expert network, internet work. If you have the solution, mobility, these are the becomes a certification. So certification is in terms of, if you want, you go through this Cisco Certified Entry Networking Technician, CCENT. There is another certification course, Cisco Certified Design Associate, CCDA. There is a one more certification, professional certification is offered by the Cisco, that is the Cisco Certified Network Associate Routing and Switching, that is the CCNA. It is very popular. CCNA is not for only the wired connection, but also the courses available for the wireless certification. So Cisco offered Cisco Certified Network Associate Wireless, CCNA Wireless. Cisco Certified Design Professional, CCDP. Cisco also Certified Network Professional Routing Switching, that is the CCNP. Look at this. This is the CCNA. This is the Network Associate Routing and Switching. This is the Professional Routing and Switching. Both courses are available. It is the certification course. You have required Certified Network Professional Wireless, CCNP Wireless. You have having the certification, professional certification, this Cisco Certified Network Expert, CCIE Routing and Switching. This is the Cisco Certified Network Expert Wireless, CCIE Wireless. Now Urba Network is also offering the certification courses, Urba Certificate Solution Professional, that SCSP, Urba Certified Mobility Associate, ACMA. उरुबा सर्टिफाइड मोबिलिटी प्रोफेशनल ACMP, दिस एक्टेल लूसेंट सर्टिफिकेशन. सो मैनी कोर्सेज आर अवेलेबल, दैट इज द नेटवर्क राउटिंग स्पेशलिस्ट 1 ग्रेड, 2nd ग्रेड, NRS 1, NRS 2. Others are also offering the, this is the CompTIA certification, this is the BICSI certification, this is the Oracle certification, Palo Alto certifications, Reputed Professional Services, RPS certification, Solar Wind certifications, WireShark certifications. And certification is also by the Wireless Network Professionals, CWNP. It is the Certified Wireless Technology Specialist, that is the CWTS, Certified Wireless Network Administrator, CWTNA, Certified Wireless Design Professional, CWDP, Certified Wireless Analysis Professional, CWAP. And here the Certified Wireless Network Expert, CWNE. You know that the Electronics Technician Association, ETA, is also offering the certification course to joining these different career options. One is the international certification. You are having this certificate course, that is called Certified Network Computer Technician, CNCT. There is another Certified Network System Technician, CNST. Another one is the Wireless Network Technician, WNT. The Extreme Network Certification is also available. The Extreme Network Certification, Certified Specialist, ECS, Stream Network Certified Expert, ECE, and Intras Certified Architect, ECA. HP also offering these certification courses. They offering the HP Expertone Networking Certification, HP Aggregated Integration Specialist, HPAIS, that is the Internet Infrastructure, HP Aggregated Solution Expert, HPASE Network Architect, HP Solution Expert, HPASE Network Infrastructure, HP Aggregated Solution Expert, HPASE Wireless Network Implementer. These three are certification are in the field of Network Architect, Network Infrastructure, and the Wireless Network Implemented. The next is HP Master Aggregated System Engineer, HP Master ASE. It is in the field of network infrastructures companies where you want to go. Last is the HP Master Aggregated System Engineer, HP ASE Master ASE, that is the Wireless Network Implementer. This is the IPv6 Forum Certification, especially for the networking. IPv6 Forum, there are the two types of the certification. One is the Silver, another one is the Gold. IPv6 Forum Silver Certificate Engineers, IPv6 Forum Gold Certification, or Juniper Network Certification courses are also available in the field of enterprises, switching, RAN routing, एज ए स्पेशलिस्ट एज ए प्रोफेशनल. इट इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल फॉर द स्विचिंग एंड राउटिंग एक्सपर्ट इंटरप्राइजेस एंड द स्पेशलिस्ट वायरलेस लैन. Now, moves towards the what is communication network is all about. The constitutional piece of data communication systems is to generalize the basic concept about your data communication systems. Start from the beginning. This topic is already I have discussed in the first lecture, but here we are having the once more for the revision purpose. Prepare the information there, because why we have taken this two lines and this dotted is signified for one row is for the source one node who are actually working there, they having the their own data, right? So data one node two PC या mobile या laptop या others communicating devices three and so on and last n number of nodes. So every nodes is first to prepare the information in a valuable form that can machine can be easily understand. That form is known as machine language. That is, machine can only understand the 0 and 1. So it is now you cannot send this data immediately. You have to change your valuable information in a bit stream, and that bit stream is converted into the data form. And then this data is actually transmit from source to through the transmitter then start to sending the data through in a available in either electrical form, or you can say other by transmission means. So all primary source, you can say it is also sometimes people are saying it is the source, some people are saying this is the your transmitter, where the information is actually originate, where the information actually create, where the information actually visualize, where the actually information is available. That nodes is known as the source. And one thing I have made very clear, if you students are known, if somebody is talking about what is the information. Information means there should be some valuable, useful knowledge. For example, if we can say a dog bites a man, everybody knows it is not information, it is not your data. But when the people are saying a man bites a dog, and when they start to say a man bites a dog, that means there is some source of information, and this information is actually transmitted, and it is converted into the bitstream form, and then sent to the connecting path that is known as the physical media. You can say it is the transmission media, or you can the connecting media. This connecting media is connected the source and the end. So there is the two ends. Obviously, one is called transmitter, और अदर इज कॉल्ड द रिसीवर. सो टू एंड्स, द फर्स्ट एंड इज योर सोर्स वन एंड इट एग्जैक्ट इंफॉर्मेशन इज नाउ एक्सर्ट फ्रॉम द अदर सोर्स एंड अदर यूजर्स. दैट इज नथिंग बट दैट इज द रिसीवर साइड. दैट इज द ऑल्सो नोन एज द योर डेस्टिनेशन साइड. तो रिसीवर रिसीव्ड द सिग्नल, एक्सट्रैक्ट द सिग्नल फ्रॉम द फिजिकल मीडिया एंड आफ्टर द एक्सट्रैक्ट द इंफॉर्मेशन इट कन्वर्टेड इनटू द यूजफुल डेटा फॉर्म. और दैट यूजफुल डेटा फॉर्म जीरो वाज नाउ कन्वर्टेड इनटू योर दैट इज द कॉल्ड डेटा, दैट इज इंफॉर्मेशन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ टेक्स्ट, ऑडियो, वीडियो, विजुअल इमेज. You see, and then it delivered your destination. Then it goes to your destination. So, what we see here a systematic view of data communication with a set of sources sending to sets of destination across this shared media. There is a one main concern. Once you open your PC or your mobile, you are always open your email, right? This is known as one source. If we denoted by S source, that is known as one source. You also browse a WhatsApp, right? Only यहाँ पे तो नहीं रुकते लोग. ये आप ही के प्लेटफॉर्म पे, आप ही के सिस्टम पे, दिस इज द become as a your source. You also open the YouTube. You have browsed the YouTube. This is known as S3. In similar fashion, there is a SN number of information is created by the same user on the same time at the same place at the same platform, and the data which you have here, that is the different it, here you can watch the videos, that is the picture, here you have chatting, here you have sending the emails. This is in the form of text, audio and video, and so many forms are here you have created and then sent. Now, this is the simplest conceptual piece of data communication network. Now, see the other. What happened when at the sender ends? Actually, what you can say, sender karta kya hai in data communication, ye janna bahut zaruri hai hamare liye. To jo information source one ne wahan pe create ki thi, wo jayegi, it goes to source encoder. ये आपके सोर्स इंपोर्टर पे जाएगी, और सोर्स इंपोर्टर क्या करता है, जो इंफॉर्मेशन जैसे यूट्यूब पे आपने देखा है तो उसको आपके उस पिक्चर के फॉर्म में रखेगा, ऑडियो वीडियो के फॉर्म में रखेगा, जो आपने व्हाट्सएप पे देखा है, जो आपने मैसेज देखा है सेंड किया है या कुछ पिक्चर देखा है वो टेक्स्ट के फॉर्म में रखेगा, आपने जो ईमेल भेजा है जो कि अल्फाबेटिकल लैंग्वेज में होगा उसके लिए भी वो एक ASCII कोड जनरेट करता है कोड, लेकिन वो ASCII कोड आप तो समझ नहीं सकते, तो उसको भी वो क्या करेगा, इंपोर्ट करेगा ताकि ये समझ सके मशीन यहाँ से यहाँ आने पे when they start to move from this blocks to this block here, the actual problem is has been started. The problem is nothing but it is the OS, different machine having the different types of the software, different types of the OS. So they can understand only their own languages. So what happened when the Chinese is talking to the American people, they can only speak the English, or Chinese can speak only the Chinese. If Indian is talk to the Russian, Russian is only speak in talk, and they share the information in only Russian, and you all only talk in Hindi. So what happened? There is a mismatch. They, you cannot the share the information. The information cannot be executed, and it is not valuable. Both and the end are unknown to each other. So they know that, they know to each other there is a encryptor, scrambler. Encryptor is there. An encryptor, after this block, it goes to channel encoding. Suitable channel. Agar if you open the WhatsApp, then it send to only the WhatsApp. What the channel they have provided you. And same thing is only received. You can only send. This is received only when the both the parties are agreed. So your end user also having the WhatsApp, and both are agreed, then it is received by the other ends. You can send the data by using the WhatsApp, you can send the data by YouTube, or so many things. And this information is multiplexer in the network, internet. And in your system, this multiplexers are ready to deliver to the physical channel, physical transmission medium. And this is only done by the modulation. The modulation is done in the modulator. There are so many suitable modulation techniques are available. You know the four suitable techniques. Once the analog to analog communication is happened, there is this suitable techniques. When analog to digital communication is required, you know the that communication. When the digital to analog communication is required, you also know that. When the digital to digital communication is required, you there is also a communication ASK, BSK, PVSK, and ASK. After the modulation, it goes to the physical channel. That channel is known how, where this data is going. And network is internet. Internet platform is delivered your network from sender ends. Now coming on the receiver ends. Your data is available in the physical channels. From the physical, it is received, and demodulator technique has demodulated, and demux means so many information coming from source 1, 2, 3, and so on, and it is distributed a different destination. Source 1 is distributed, the source 1 channel decoder is decode your information, then it decrypt your information for your own language, for the other user who are sitting there for other end side. And the source decoders are decode and converted in your valuable data representation form. Either it is the your text or your PDF or your file, your PPT or your video, audio, images, others you can send the pictures, movies. The source decoder are start to decode your valuable information and deliver to the destination. Same thing is happened here. The information which is coming from the YouTube, it is going to you. Other platforms, other user, okay, you can write their destination name. This is the conceptual piece of communication. And we are learning the data communication network. Here, you can see the basic block diagram of communication model. This is the basic block diagram of communication model. The question arises, how many components are required in data communication networks? This is the solution for this particular answer. How many components are required in data communication network? You can see here, there is a one block. You can say it is the sender, you can say it is the source, whatever the name. It either source, it is the sender, same thing. The first is block is source, second block is receiver, that is the destination. The third is the communicating, connecting, transmission medium. This is the third one. And fourth one is the your masses. And fifth one is your protocol. So there are total number of five components has been utilized in to represent your basic block diagram of data communication networks. Five components. First component is source, that is known as sender. Here we have written sender. Second one is, that is the another end user. This is the users, end users. And this is also the end user. See, both are connecting to each other. That means this is a communication. And they have exchanging the information through the transmission media. Okay. And both the parties are agreed. Both the end parties are agreed. They have to follow the sets of rules. This is the sets of rules. So, the five components you can see here. Again, I have repeated the basic building block diagram, basic conceptual piece of diagram is different, and basic block diagram of communication model DCN is different, or both are the having the different block diagram. So here you can write, this is the DCN. There are the five components. First is the sender, second is the receiver, third is the your transmission medium, fourth is your masses, and last one is your protocol. It is the written software algorithm protocol which execute on your network, on your PC, on your communicating devices, either you can say mobile, your laptop, other things which are connecting through the internet. You have to agree by this sets of rule, otherwise you cannot connected with this DCN data communication network. You cannot utilize the internet. So the five component, first is sender. Sender ka kya kaam hai? Sender is send the data. It transmit the data in the form of bit stream. So the sender is originate the information and converted into the valuable machine language zeros and ones, and that conversion is done at the sender side, and they having the bit stream, and that bit stream is sent through this transmission medium, and transmission medium is connected to the other end, and here the receiver block. Receiver is received the signal, whatever the data form is sent by the sender. Message is nothing but it is the useful information. Useful information. And this is fifth component, sets of rule. Every sets of rule for the different work, different for, we can say, first rule is all for your how the wireless communicating device is working. Second rule is for how the LAN, WAN is working, and another one, how the process is going on, how the data is executing. How third rule is which type of the network you have to require. Fourth one is what is your protocols when they are connecting to each other. This protocol is must be either be BP, V6, V4 according to your configurations. This protocols is important in data communication network. So the question is arises, what is the actual definition of data communication? The data communication is a system consisting of carries and related devices used to transport data from one point to the another point. That means the communication to convey a message and a idea or a picture or a speech, that is the voice, this that is received and understood clearly, correctly by the person for whom it is conveyed. And communication system is a combination of hardware and software, and data is transferred links that makes up a communication facility for transferring the data in the cost effective and efficient manner. So a data communication system, it can be either analog or digital. The technique by which digital signal is converted into an analog form is known as modulation, and modulation is done in the modulator. The reverse process, that is the conversion of analog signal to the digital signal, is known as demodulation, where the digital signal is converted to analog, that is the modulation. Okay, when the reverse process, analog signal is converted to digital signal, that is the known as demodulation. This process of conversion carried out by the spatial devices, that is known as modem. So recap of our today lectures. the what are the components of the data communication system. First one is the message. You can serial this number according to your own choice. Message is the information to be communicated by the sender to the receiver. So this is the sender. The sender is any device that is capable of sending the data message. What is the receiver? Receiver is a device that the sender wants to communicate the message. Transmission. Transmission medium, it is the path by which the message travels from sender to receiver. It can be wired or wireless or many subtypes in both. Protocol, it is an agreed upon sets or rules used by sender and receiver to communicate data. What is the protocol? Protocol is the sets of rules that govern the data communication, and protocol is a necessity in the data communication without which the communicating entities are like two persons trying to talk to each other in a different language without knowing the other language. So it is the today end of lecture. Our thank you very much.